so we're going to start now. You know, I have kept 5 chits there. So there are 5 groups, right? So one member from the group can come and pick up a chit from here. Come on. One member each. And if you can read out, so you will be number 4 in presentation, second, fifth, first, all right, third, okay, so that's going to be the sequence, all right. So when we received your, you know, submittals that you gave us, we have evaluated it, okay, and 60% of marks are for that. We have done an evaluation. 40% is going to be for what you are going to do now. All right? So it's not necessary that if you have scored well in your, the way you have, you know, presented it, you also need to do a good job here as well and take the cross questioning which will happen. Okay? And as you will present, you know, we will be about a couple of, you know, guys from my office. There's one architect, Mr. Anant Raman from Mysore, you know, who is going to be part of the evaluation. We wanted a faculty from a Nagpur college who wanted to come, but he had a slip disk, so could not come, so we requested him. He's also visiting faculty in School of Planning and Architecture in Mysore. A colleague of mine, architect Nandini Bazaz, should walk in any time now. Myself, I am Dr. Vivek Desai, okay. I run a company called Hosmac, which is in field of hospital planning and architecture. Okay, planning and management actually. So we do, we are a group of doctors, architects, MEP engineers, interior designers, biomedical engineers, okay, and MBA graduates in hospital management. That's what the company is all about. We have office in Bombay, Bangalore, Delhi, and we have a fully owned subsidiary in Dubai. We are a team of 150 people. All right, so we have in our office about 35 architects as well. Okay, so we probably might be a future recruiter, you know, in case you intend to practice healthcare architecture in future. We get students to do internship with us. You know, my own son is in final year of architecture, okay, doesn't believe in healthcare architecture, that's why he's not here. You know, he's more into urban design and, you know, something like that is in his mind. So. On that note, we will start if you have all your presentations loaded here, right? Okay. All right, so we are all set to start. So the first, you know, competitor can come on stage, please, number one, drinking water. We'll give you water here also, don't worry. Okay, please come on stage and start your presentation. Give a brief about yourself, your college also.
Good afternoon, one and all. I'm Ankita Sharma. These are Vaishali Kumari and Aparna Bagaria. We are fourth year students from the Department of Architecture at Birla Institute of Technology, Mesra. Good afternoon. So assisted living, as we all know, is an very fast emerging concept. It takes responsibility for healthcare and personal needs of mentally and physically frail senior citizens in a residential context more than an institutional one. Our project, Parigraha, offers a chance for our senior denizens to embrace life and live it to the fullest in the lap of nature. Parigraha in Sanskrit means to offer solace in a comfortable embrace. It is from this meaning that we derive our design inspiration. The basic concepts that guided our thought process was a home-like surrounding, provision of privacy and recognizing the uniqueness of each resident, interdependence, independence, and individuality, maintaining a connection with the surroundings, the environment, the interaction of nature and culture, and the healing benefits of activities such as walking, jogging, physical and mental therapy, and animal therapy. Our site is located in Kharakwasla, Pune, Maharashtra. The climate is temperate, with an average temperature of 24.7 degrees Celsius. The prevailing wind direction in the summer was west, and in the winters, north. It is well connected to the cities of Mumbai and Pune. The site area, our site area was 22,500 square meters. We have considered this site ideal for the project because it has a well-balanced climate which reduces the need for artificial ventilation. It is well connected and it has a very good scope for amenities and a very scenic location because it is surrounded by a lot of gardens and lakes and hills. And it also provided some isolation from the noisy cities. Our site plan. We planned the site keeping in mind the orientation required by the various design spaces. For instance, the habitable spaces face south and east. The pet shelter and the common spaces get ample north light, and the clinical areas face west. The concept,
The concept for the internal zoning has been derived from the functions and connectivity required by different spaces. For instance, to maximize accessibility while ensuring privacy, there are two different wards for the elderly residents and one specifically for the differently abled. This orientation utilizes the south and east sunlight. Nurses' stations have been provided along with both the wards and the ICU. And a separate staff resident residence has been placed adjacent to the differently abled wards to ensure better supervision. The animal therapy center is placed in the north to provide a diffuse light to the shelters and the courtyards. The common spaces have been provided centrally to in close proximity to the wards in the south and east respectively. To ensure proper ventilation, courtyards have been strategically incorporated in the design. Thus, we can see that the design encompasses climate-responsive architecture, sustainable design, universal and therapeutic design, courtyard-type planning, and a pet therapy center. Climate-responsive architecture. The climate-responsive features in our design include east-west orientation of the building. The wards have exposure to the south sun, green cover on the west wall to reduce heat load, vertical fins inclined at an angle on the west face to avoid direct sunlight, maximum exposure of daylight on the south and north facade. The west side has a pool of water which cools the air as it passes over the and the vertical wooden fins let the cooled air enter the courtyard, thus cooling the surrounding areas. Curtain wall on the north has been provided to block cold winter winds while letting in diffused light. The sustainable design features in our design include rainwater harvesting requisites, the use of materials and construction techniques indigenous to Maharashtra region like slope roofs, use of stone and wood, internal courtyards, etc. Materials used are fly ash bricks for the walls, micro concrete roofing tiles, stone, wooden fins have been used. These are also easy to maintain and require minimal care. The planning has been done considering orientation within the environment that reduces confusion and facilitates wayfinding. The built spaces have been placed such that they reflect the planning of a small town where the central common areas are surrounded by residential units, the clinical area, and the animal therapy center. The corridors resemble the street of a town, justifying our theme for the street style planning.
Can someone explain that?
Yeah, I'll just move on to that. Now I'll be highlighting the different areas in the plan. First of all, we see this face, which is the west facade, it has a water body. As we told, the summer winds is from the west. So we need to cool it when it enters the building. So over here, you can see there are vertical wooden fins, which ensure the cool air enters the courtyard and it enters the adjacent rooms. So now we have the elderly resident wards. They have a nurse station adjacent to them, and they are arranged linearly, giving the corridor the resemblance of a street. This is the view where you can see all the rooms have a porch type of structure outside the room, which gives it an appearance of a house. So they feel like they're living in their houses, and when they come out, it's like a street. The wards are placed on the south, as the south sun has therapeutic value. Moving on to the clinical areas, they have the consultation rooms, the labs, the sterile storage, technician room, wet and dry waste, ICUs, toilets, etc. These are placed on the west because most of them do not require natural ventilation, and labs, sterile storage, etc., they generally require artificial ventilation. And also the west wall has green cover, which acts as an insulator and thus reduces the heat load. The on-duty staff residence is placed in the proximity to the differently abled wards. The curtain wall on the north cuts the cold winds and facilitates north light entry into the region. Over here, we can also see a jali work, which is done to ensure light entrance to the courtyards. And over here, the west walls have been covered with the greens to reduce the heat load. Now, this shows the animal therapy center. They have been placed in the north, keeping in mind the requirement of diffuse light continuously in their kennels or shelters. The pets in the care home can be therapeutic for residents. People suffering from physical and mental health issues have reported feeling calmer when in the presence of pet, cat, or dog. Some residents also get a very few or no visitors sometimes, and these pets can make them feel loved and included. Now, the common areas. It includes the common room, library, store, therapy room, physiotherapy room, and prayer room, which are very vital for living comfortably, and also the dining hall and kitchen. We can see they are in the center. They are well connected to both the differently abled section and also the elderly people section. So they can both access them easily. And the kitchen has a separate service entry from the outside, and they provide a wide range of activities. And natural ventilation is ensured by the courtyards present around them. Now we have a perspective view. We'll be highlighting the different views we have. This is the north face, which has the curtain wall for cutting the cold winds and also to provide entry for the north light. This is the west face, which has the pool, which cools the air, and it enters through the wooden fins into the courtyards. This is a view of the wooden fins. Over here is the emergency entry for the ICU and the clinical areas. And this is the area outside the elderly wards, where they have a jogging track and a park to relax and spend some quality time with all the other residents. We have a small walkthrough of the whole project we have made. This is the west wall, which has all the green cover. Now it goes to the park and the jogging track. The emergency entry, which has been separated from the elderly residence ward by natural fencing. There are courtyards in between, and this is the north wall, which has the curtain, north side, which has the curtain wall. And that's the whole side. Now, what are final sheets? I don't know if you have seen it or not. These are final sheets. And in conclusion, we would like to thank the jury and audience for their time and attention. Working for this project has been extremely educationally inspiring. We hope you enjoyed our presentation, and thank you, all of you, and good luck to all the upcoming teams.
All right, so, you know, from the jury, if there are questions.
You were talking about this being a place for elderly.
Yes.
Who are disabled, who cannot walk, or probably they need assistance.
Yes.
The critical areas are places, the toilets, the bathrooms, in so many places. You are never shown any detail related to how these spaces are going to be approached and used. There are so many facilities which has to be used. There should be some basic sort of guidelines as well as the dimensions of how much of to require for bathing, for a person to use the toilet, and what are the fixtures which goes into. There is the absence of that detail which has to be looked at. Secondly, you are talking about those individual cottage sort of a thing which was opening on to a street like thing. Nice as a gesture, but there you are showcasing it as being a green space. You know, the corridor.
Yeah.
Yes. Sir.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes,
sir. Okay. So here we don't know whether it is covered on top.
Oh, sorry. I'm so sorry. I missed the point. It is covered on the top with translucent sheets which enter, which provide entry to the natural lighting.
Why I'm telling you is, in case of rains, in case of so many
I'm
things.
I'm so sorry. I skipped the point. I'm really sorry.
These are vital points you have to make.
Sorry.
And again, the garden need not be, you know, in the street, because people have to be moved in, you know, wheelchairs and so many things. And if you have greenery there, you know, how exactly it may have its own problem. So the type of material you are going to use.
No, it's not. It's not a garden. It's just carpeted area.
Artificial.
Just to give it the look of a street, the materials are modified.
Even carpeting has got its own problem. You know, you have a lot of dust mites, so many things.
Right.
So the rightful.
Yeah, it's carpeted.
Yeah, the rightful usage of material is to be understood.
Okay.
And even you could have broken down the corridor. See, it need not be a street-like phenomenon.
Okay.
There's so many things which would have broken it up so that people would have come into these common spaces. What if two or three rooms, it open up into a small buffer space, and these elderly people like to have a dialogue. They need to see. Usually what happens, our age-old people, once people age, hardly there are anyone to talk to them.
Yeah.
You know, the children, everyone are there in their own world.
Hmm. And pet area will help them do that?
No, that is, pet area is somewhere far off. And here we see there should have been certain very interesting spaces, pockets you should have created, where you could have opened up to this primary green spaces, where it could have been some sort of a connect between these, by the virtue of which people find it relaxed. Now I feel it is claustrophobic. Please don't mistake.
No,
being critical.
Completely. That's a valid point.
Going
so you should have had those breathable spaces. These people would like to come, sit there, chat.
Chat, yeah.
You know, so many things. But that is how they communicate, socialize. The more they socialize, they don't feel lonely. In fact, they feel they are in the right place.
Right.
Otherwise, they would feel that this is a place where their children have abandoned them.
Okay, true.
You know, you should never feel that they have been abandoned here and they have come. You know? So it is not only the provision of the rightful facility, how you place them, what has to happen so that it could be very social, is very important.
Yes,
certain things I feel which could have been done better. And now, we were deliberating many issues related to energy management and things like that. You have a lot of flat roofs. Right?
Yes, sir.
All these flat roofs.
So can you tell us, you know, because it's too much of criticism, you don't get nervous, all right? Can you talk about some of the features about sustainability that you have taken? See, that north, west, east or south and all that is a very, you know, that everyone knows. But is there anything else that you have tried to do? Like what he said, if the roof is flat, probably might be difficult for you to.
Now, how you could utilize it? You can use it for solar paneling. Passive solar as well as active solar.
You
should put those things.
Okay.
By and large, the presentation is good. The basics have been done right. But the thing is the aspect of design, the involvement of design. You have to think in the minds of who is the end user.
Okay.
And maintaining these facilities require a lot of money. And sustainable resources like solar water heating, yes, all these things help in reducing the cost.
Overall cost.
Okay. Yes. So these features have to be looked upon.
Well, congratulations to the entire team. Good package, good green building research, I would say. We must appreciate and walk through and everything. Probably within given stipulated time, you had worked a lot.
Thank you, sir.
So congrats. That's
thank
it.
You. Thank you, sir.
It was good. And just wanted to ask you about, because it's for assisted living, have you considered aspects like, as in when a sort of elderly people would sort of prefer more of a breakout space and more to go into the landscape area, but at the same time be sort of, you know, protected and safeguarded by some elements. But I didn't notice any of those aspects here. As in for a simple thing, like for example, if somebody's going to walk on a tiled paved area next to a garden, what sort of protective elements have you used as a part of the design? Can you just maybe tell me, yeah, elaborate?
I would, if you can see the second picture over there. Which one is the photo? Okay. This one. Over here. Now, this is an area adjacent to the courtyard. We have provided railings all along, as in, at around 900 mm, we have provided railings all around the space for them to have an assistance while walking, maybe, or on the wheelchair. And also, there's texture on the wall, as in the walls have been textured, they're not smooth. It might help the visually impaired people to walk.
What about memory loss? Patients with memory loss, are you going to create some sort of, what do you say, like focal points or some noticeable points for them to come back to that location so that they can then kind of orient or themselves to go in the unit? Have you thought about that?
No. So sorry, we haven't.
No.
I would really work on it.
I'd like to add a comment saying, as a student, you have great potential and possibility to go beyond whatever you have seen. As a professional, we are designing many places, many buildings, many large towers also. We have to limit our imaginations, creativity, considering cost and stuff like that. So I would say, whenever you are doing another project in academics, please push your creativity to the limits. That's it.
Yeah, I would agree with sir. So,
can you just also give a little back from where and
okay. So I am an architect from Chandigarh. I also go as visiting faculty for design in different universities.
Okay.
So I think a lot of points have been covered. So I would just bring few observations. I would bring these observations because you would be presenting your thesis in the coming year, right?
Yes.
So there were certain things which you shouldn't do. So when you were talking about the site, well connected is not the term, okay? It's for elderly people, so hospital has to be nearby. So you'll have to tell about these places, how close are they.
Okay.
Okay, well connected is not the word. Sure. Then, in your entire presentation, I could not get what was your concept. What was the base of your concept?
Okay.
How
telling
it evolved.
Exactly, how, what was the evolution? Saying that it's home-like does not solve it, okay? So,
okay.
As an architect, you should, you know, take more advantage of your drawing skills than words.
Okay.
Your presentation should not have words. It should be more about how you explain it rather than those words and you read it out, right? Images, your sketches, it should be full of your sketches.
Okay.
Because that would help you in going to a creative journey rather than restricting your whole thing. I would also suggest you, next time whenever you do any healthcare thing, you guys need to, you know, do much more research. Your ICU area and all that was completely wrong. The way you had put your toilets within the ICU, a lot of other things were completely wrong. So study that. Also applies to any architecture project. You are not studying the psychology of the user. So you're giving a prayer room right next to the corridor. These are elderly people who would have mood swings. Okay, so one chota sa room right next to the corridor would not solve that purpose. So build a little more sensitive to what the users need, right? All the best for your future.
Okay. I'm Architect Shivang from Chandigarh. First of all, I need to tell you that you have done a very good job.
Thank you so much.
And which software have you used?
We have used SketchUp and Revit for the isometric view.
Okay.
And Lumion for rendering.
And for the final presentation, sheets have been made in?
Sheets are on Photoshop and the presentation is on PPT.
Good. Now I have few questions. What is your entire site area? I missed that.
It's 22,500 square meter.
And how much of it have you used? What percentage?
We have used 25% is the built-up area.
Okay.
And that's the ground coverage is 25%. Mm-hmm. Greens are 56%, and the road area, as in the circulation of the vehicular path, is 16%.
That's good. So now, as ma'am has also told you earlier, you need to look more into the psychology of the person for whom you're designing. That aspect is a bit missing. Architecturally, it's a good project you have done. You have completed it. And you need to understand more about the psychology of the user. And also, the people who are going to assist them, those I feel that they have been left out somewhere in the design.
Hi, my name is Nandini. I'm an architect with Hosmac India since 10, 12 years. There are just two issues which I'll bring along. The rest everybody's covered, and congratulations. Good job done, I would also agree. One, the orientations east, south, and west is really loud currently. Two, the housing windows. Your longer sides are towards harsh sun in the greater part of the day. Second, I am just unable to see the segregation of housing men, women, and couples separately. Have you thought of that?
Actually, we had it in our mind that they would stay in different rooms. That's all.
We didn't consciously.
Yeah, they
do.
Old age couples?
Yes, they do.
Yeah.
All the bedrooms are
they're twin sharing.
Yeah, they are.
I don't see single sharing.
Okay.
You could bring these in. Think about these aspects also. That's it.
My only point is that your site is in Pune, Maharashtra, right? So do you think that this much water body in between your building is a good option to put? Because the humid level is obviously high there.
Okay.
So what do you think about it, and how you are going to defend it in your design? Like,
the only purpose of providing the water body was to cool the summer winds which were entering, and
all right. I think there's too much of grilling. Yeah. I think it's a. No, point well taken. You know, you need to, what it's trying to tell you that it might humidify the surrounding, so you need to understand that. I think, did you follow the space program which was given to you?
Yes,
or
yes, we did.
So were there so many ICU rooms given?
There were two,
there were two ICU beds given. You have made, two separate ICU sections only. Yeah, so you've not followed the brief properly.
Provided that.
ICU?
Yes.
Okay.
The area was 160 square meter in total.
So you have given two full-blown ICU, so much of ICU care is not required in, assisted living center. But I think presentation-wise, I quite like that. What was the software you said? Lumion.
Lumion.
Yeah. So that probably has helped you to do that, the walkthrough view quite well. So, I think thank you very much. All the best. Let's hope who wins. We don't know.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
So, just to, tell the jury as well as the others here that we had given them a briefing document that this should have so much of build-up area, what kind of rooms and all of that, so the ICU probably came from there. There's also the first winner is going to get a cash prize of 60,000, second winner 30,000, and third winner 15,000. So the stakes are high. All right. So yes. Pardon?
Yeah. There was two ICU units. It was mentioned in the problem sheets also.
Okay, but number of beds probably were not so many.
They were right, like it's two units, individual units.
So two units means two cubicles.
Yes, sir.
In our language.
Two spaces. We thought of two spaces and.